controlling a user's login and password is fundamental to managing a Salesforce user. In Salesforce, you can control the when, the how, and the where a user can log in from. This is important for security and for making sure that you only have people that you actually want in Salesforce. We can control how users log in many, many different ways. The key tools that we have are login hours, the login IP range, trusted IP range, and session timeout. So we're going to start with login hours. Login hours control the days and the hours that users with this profile are allowed to log in. We might say that sales users can only log in from Monday to Friday, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. But maybe the tech team should be able to log in anytime, any day of the week. No problem, we can just use login hours to make that happen. Since we set the login hours for each profile, you can find these settings on the profile. The login IP range is our second tool that we can use, and this controls who can log in by looking at each user's IP address. Now, what is an IP address? An IP address is kind of like your home's physical address, but for your computer. So instead of having a street and a mailbox number, you have just a long number for your computer that is completely unique. In Salesforce, we can set a range of IP addresses that people can log in from. Anyone who tries to log in from a computer that is outside that range of IP addresses just won't be able to. It's kind of like stopping people from coming into your company doors from a dodgy neighborhood that you're just saying, no, thank you. This is especially useful if we only want people logging into Salesforce from their work laptops. We just put the work laptop IP range there and no one else is going to be able to log in. We also have another tool available to us, the trusted IP range. This is different from the login IP range. While the login IP range will completely stop people from being able to log into Salesforce, the trusted IP range controls whether or not we want people to be using multi-factor authentication. If your computer's IP address is within the trusted IP range, it means that Salesforce trusts you and you do not need to use multi-factor authentication to log in. If your computer's IP address falls outside of this trusted IP range, you can still log in, but you'll just have to use multi-factor authentication first. The final tool that we can use to control how users log in is called a session timeout. Now, session timeouts control how long Salesforce will let you stay logged in before they automatically kick you out and make you re-log back in. This helps to massively reduce the security risk that happens when people are working in Salesforce, they leave their computers open, and then they wander away, and someone else might happen to be walking past and then have full access to their Salesforce org. You can stop this by controlling your session timeout, and this is set at the org level by simply searching for session settings and setup, or even you can choose to set it at the profile level just by going to the appropriate user's profile. So we've covered all the different ways a user can log into Salesforce, but what about viewing the login history for your Salesforce org? Who logged in today? Where did they come from? Is there any suspicious activity that's going on? We can check all of this in Salesforce. If we wanted to view the entire login history for everyone in your Salesforce org, we can do this by going to the login history in our setup menu. That one is nice and easy to remember. All the words seem to make sense. Login history to get your login history. Here you can get the full export of all of the logins over a certain period of time. You can get the who logged in, the where, the when. You can see their username, you can see their location, you can see their computer's IP address, what browser they were logging in from, what URL they used to get there, and you can download the whole thing as a .csv file or a zip file. It's super handy. The second place that we can go to check up on someone's login history is their user account. Here you can see some key details, things like last login, last password change or reset, and the number of failed login attempts under the user details section. Or you can see all of their successful or unsuccessful login attempts in the login history related list, which is just at the bottom of that page. Every time a user enters their correct username when they log in, Salesforce is going to record their login as an attempt on their user record. If they don't have the correct username, it's not going to be recorded, because how would Salesforce know which user to record that login attempt against? This is actually super useful information to know, because if a user comes to you and they're saying, you know, "Hi, Salesforce admin, I can't log in, I've tried 100 times and it's just not letting me," then you can go to their login history and you can tell if they were using their correct username, you'd see their failed login attempts. But if you don't see any login attempts at all, it means that they didn't even have their username correct, which can help you solve the problem much faster. Passwords are the final piece of the puzzle. As a Salesforce admin, you can control almost every aspect of a user's password creation. You can set the minimum password length, the password complexity, does it need special characters, does it need numbers? You can set the password expiry time, the maximum number of invalid login attempts, and how long it will lock you out from Salesforce if you hit that limit. You can enforce a backup password question and even stop people from reusing old passwords. Everyone loves that one. You can control these settings for your entire organization by going to Password Policies in the Setup menu, or you can control them by individual profile. If you don't trust those sales reps, they're a shady bunch, then you could make the minimum password length 12 characters. You could make it include numbers, alphabets, and special characters. It's totally up to you as a Salesforce admin and your company's kind of security policies. The final thing to cover here is resetting passwords. Trust me, it's going to be quite a frequent activity for any Salesforce admin. Fortunately, it's super easy to do. We just go to Users and Setup, search for whichever user whose password you want to reset, and then just click on the Reset Password button right at the top. You can even generate a multi-factor authentication code for a user if they've left their phone at home, but they still want to get into Salesforce. So that's logins and passwords. We've covered a whole bunch here. We've gone through login hours, login IP ranges, trusted IP ranges, session timeouts. We've viewed login histories, password policies, and we've gone through password resets. So great job. It's time to jump into Salesforce and try this.